Some 2,000 singers have passed through the Dallas Street Choir in the last 5 years. The idea is to boost spirits while people try to get back on their feet and to raise public awareness about what it means to be homeless. Jeffrey Brown went to Dallas recently to see the nation's largest street choir at work. The report is part of our occasional series on homelessness without a home and our ongoing coverage of Arts and Culture Canvas.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there?
A lifting of voices at Wednesday morning rehearsal, where the words from the song You Will Be Found hold real meaning.
Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay.
This is the Dallas Street Choir, whose members carry their worldly belongings with them, including sleeping bags used the previous night in shelters and outdoors.
You will be found.
Jonathan Pallant is the group's founder and conductor.
It's wonderful that we have such a large choir here in Dallas because so many people are taking from this choir. They're receiving the benefits of music, of family, of togetherness. It's also sad that we have so many people that require such a service. I would love for this just to be the Dallas Choir, but it's not. It has to be the street choir.
The Stew Pot in downtown Dallas is a day shelter that offers food, clothing, health, and other services, even an art studio.
Good morning.
And once a week, those who want to sing line up outside for a fist bump welcome.
Good morning.
Mm-hmm. Good morning.
And an hour's worth of music and uplift, along with a snack and a $2 bill for their efforts.
There you go, my friend.
Pallant, a professor at the University of Texas, Dallas, started the street choir 5 years ago. When Credo, one of several choruses he leads, largely white, middle class, employed or retired, was given a piece of music to sing that told of the hardships of living on the street. Something felt wrong.
It didn't make sense unless we were to incorporate the community, unless we were to reach out, unless we were to educate.
Why was it obvious, though, that music would be the way in to reach these people?
I am simply using what it is I do to bring people together. I think the arts in general are a powerful tool to tear down walls and barriers and perceptions and stigmas and stereotypes to show that we're really much more the same than we are apart.
The Dallas Street Choir has been a success. It now presents some 15 concerts a year at schools, churches, and large corporate gatherings, often performing alongside other choruses. And in 2017, having gotten the attention and support of important opera figures like singer Frederica von Stade,
ladies and gentlemen of the Dallas Street Choir,
the group even sang at Carnegie Hall.
Find a seat, let's go.
But that doesn't change the day-to-day circumstances for these people who came to homelessness through a litany of causes, including addiction, mental illness, job loss and evictions, and in some cases, convictions and incarceration. During our visit, 55-year-old Daryl Payne, who'd served time in prison and is now in a shelter, took one of the leads on the Paul Simon song, Gone at Last.
I head along streets of bad love, but I pray it's gone at last.
My prayers goes out to those people out there on the streets, cause it hurt me deep down inside.
One more time!
What does coming to the street choir do for you?
It makes me grow stronger. Makes my voice stronger.
The mantra of the Dallas Street Choir, homeless, not voiceless.
All right.
Misty Zacharias is another Wednesday regular. She's an artist as well as a singer.
I think it was an empty spot inside of me, and I didn't even know about it until I heard them singing. I get to meet beautiful people, you know.
To meet beautiful people.
Yes, yeah. They are beautiful. No matter what they're going through, you know. Some of them, they've been really hurting. But regardless of anything, if you ask them, they're going to give you a big smile back and say, good morning.
The problem here in Dallas, though, as in other U.S. cities, is growing worse, seen at the public library and elsewhere. Some members of the street choir spend their nights at the Bridge Homeless Recovery Center, a large facility that takes in some 800 people a day and offers 24/7 support, including physical and mental health care. Chief Development Officer Nick Coletti is proud of the work done here. It's received national attention. But he also notes the paradox of rising homelessness, 9% jumps each of the past 2 years, in a city with a booming economy.
We do have a shortage of affordable housing solutions for folks here in Dallas. We all understand that when it comes to homelessness, every one of us is one single catastrophic moment away from being homeless, whether it's a medical catastrophe, whether you lose your job, you're evicted, whatever could happen, right?
And go.
Two choir members we met experienced that kind of sudden shift. 64-year-old Bjorn Herman grew up in Sweden and told us he'd had a restaurant equipment business here before losing it and eventually his home several years ago. His friend, 54-year-old Jesse C., grew up in Dallas and says he once made a good living and had a 3-bedroom house before DUI violations and 3 years in prison led where he is today, a life filled with a new kind of stress.
Having to think about, you know, where I'd rather be opposed to where I am. It can get really stressful out here, and it's sometimes dangerous.
The choir has been a big thing for all of us right now. It's kind of like a getaway to something that we'd love to do. It gives me like a spiritual peace to sing.
You know, being homeless is not a disability.
On this day, in fact, Jesse C. told the group he just left the streets and was living with family again.
I hopefully will not become homeless again. I'm really going to try hard not to. I'm looking for a brighter future.
You going to keep singing here?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh, absolutely.
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 We wouldn't let Jonathan down for anything.
No. No.
Jonathan Pallant is used to that loyalty from his street singers. He's also used to a question raised as we talked in a storage room filled with basic supplies for the homeless.
Resources being put into music, to a choir. Why is that the place to put resources?
What we offer through music is personal integrity. You may not have four walls, but our singers will tell you four walls a home does not make.
I do believe if I hadn't met you.
And this message is spreading. Pallant heads a network called the National Alliance for Music in Vulnerable Communities, with music programs now in 12 cities. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in Dallas.
Personal integrity and a whole lot more. What a wonderful story.